ॐ शन्नो मित्रशं वरुणः शन्नो भवत्वर्यमा शन्न इन्द्रो बृहस्पतिः शन्नो विष्णुरुरुक्रमः नमो ब्रह्मणे नमस्ते वायो त्वमेव प्रत्यक्षं ब्रह्मासि त्वमेव प्रत्यक्षं ब्रह्म वदिष्यामि ऋतं वदिष्यामि सत्यं वदिष्यामि तन्मामवतु तद्वक्तारमवतु अवतु माम् अवतु वक्तारम् ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः ॐ सहनावतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः श्रुतिस्मृतिपुराणानां करुणालयम् नमामि भगवत्पादम् शङ्करं लोकशङ्करं शङ्करं शङ्कराचार्यं बादरायणं सूत्रभाष्यकृतौ वन्दे भगवन्तौ पुनः पुनः ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेति मूर्तिभेदविभागिने व्योमवद्व्याप्तदेहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः ॐ पार्थाय प्रतिबोधितां भगवता नारायणेन स्वयं व्यासेन क्रतितां पुराणमुनिना मध्ये महाभारतम् अद्वैतामृतवर्षिणीं भगवती अष्टादशाध्यायिनी अम्ब त्वामनुसन्दधामि भगवद्गीते भवद्वेषिणी यं ब्रह्मा वरुणेन्द्ररुद्रमरुतः सुन्वन्ति दिव्यैस्तवैः वेदैः साङ्गपदक्रमोपनिषदैः गायन्ति यं सामगाः ध्यानावस्थिततद्गतेन मनसा पश्यन्ति यं योगिनः यस्यान्तं न विदुःसुरासुरगणाः देवाय तस्मै नमः
From verse 23
नैनं छिन्दन्ति शस्त्राणि नैनं दहति पावकः न चैनं क्लेदयन्त्यापः न शोषयति मारुतः अच्छेद्योयमदाख्योऽयम् अक्लेद्यो शोष्य एव च nityas sarvagatasthanuh. Achaloyam sanatanah. Avyaktoyam achintyoyam. Avikaryoyam uchyate. Tasmadevam viditvainam. Nanu shochitum arhasi. Atachainam nityajatam. Nityam vamanyase vrutam. Tathapitvam mahabaho. Naivam shochitum arhasi. Jatasya hi dhruvo vrutyuhu. Dhruvam janma mrutasya cha. Tasmada parihāryethe. Natvam shochitum arhasi. So, Bhagavan, Lord Krishna, is giving Arjuna the reasons why there is absolutely no reason to grieve in life. Sorrow has no place at all in life. That is what Bhagavan is explaining to Arjuna. From the very beautifully, Bhagavan delineated the nature of Atma, the Swarup of Atma, being indestructible, unmanifest, etc. And it is without any attributes, without any parts. So what is it? What can even touch Atma? Because it is partless, etc. By this it has been shown that Atma is eternal. So absolutely there is no reason to lament or grieve with reference to Atma. Then if Arjuna may question, okay, Atma is eternal, but what about the body? Body certainly departs, body certainly comes, and it certainly goes. So naturally we have been associated with a particular body for a long time. And then when the person departs or when the jiva departs, naturally we will be separated. So there will be a cause for grief, at least on that level. Bhagavan said, even that cannot be the reason to grieve. Why? Because it is to happen. The reality of Atma is that it is eternal, and the reality of Anatma or the body is that it is anitya. Atma is nitya, Anatma is ever anitya. It is bound by time, it is bound by space. So you can never expect it to be always there. It is like a glow, it is like a beep, and it is never in your control, really speaking. Whatever is asat, whatever is anitya, is never in your control. You cannot do anything much about it. So either you accept this fact of life, of anatma also, or grieve. The other alternative is, either you accept it, or you grieve. Oh, it has gone, it has gone. If you choose to grieve and not accept the reality, it is your problem. Anatma is not going to stop because of you, because of your desires or because of your expectations. It is not going to happen that Anatma or that which is going will change its course because of you. That is not going to happen. So it is better that you accept. And he also said that even if you think that Atma is being born and Atma is dying, not Anatma, but even if that is not right, but even if you think for a moment, Bhagavan is considering his point, that in case you think that Atma is being born, Nitya Jatam. Nityam Manyase Mrutam. If you think that Atma is dying every time with the death of the body, Atma dies. If you think like that, then also, Tathapi, then also, Natvam Shochitum Arhasi. Then also you should not grieve. Why? Because that is also a fact, that it is being born and it is dying. And that which has come will go. And that which goes will come back again. That is also a fact of life. That which is born dies. And that which dies again comes back. So, apariharye arthe, those things in which you cannot do anything, apariharye, which you cannot alter, in things which you cannot alter or change, why should you grieve? If you could change it, if you could order, oh rain, don't come now. Don't come. And if rain heard you, then it is okay. But even if you pray, even if you order, it does what it has to do. If it wants to rain, it will. If it doesn't want to rain, it will not. You cannot do anything about this. You may wish that sun should not rise. I want to sleep little longer. Sun should not rise. Then also it rises at the set time. You may wish that it should rise and it should not go. It should go. Nothing you cannot control. You just cannot control. In things which you cannot control, in things which you cannot change, better accept. That why should you cry about it? Where is the need to cry? So, Bhagavan is very clear that as far as the paramarthic reality is concerned, there also there is no reason for sorrow. And as far as vyavharika reality is concerned, even there is no reason for sorrow if you accept it. If you accept. Grief comes only and only when you don't accept. Grief is the result of our non-acceptance of the facts. It is as simple as that. Our non-acceptance about things, about the things which we cannot change, we cannot control, and still we don't want to accept, then only sorrow comes. There are certain things where you can do something about your own self, about your own nature. You can do something. You can bring about a change in your nature. You can work harder. As far as your action is concerned, you have a choice to do, not to do, etc. But as far as other things are concerned, non-self, you have absolutely no say. Bhagavan has given you no say. This is my area. You don't enter into this. So better accept it. And one more reason now Bhagavan gives for not grieving. What is that? Verse 28 we will see.
Avyaktadini bhutani. Vyaktamadhyani Bharat. Avyaktanidhananyeva. Tatraka paridevana.
See, now Bhagavan says, see, he is giving him another perspective. Another dimension of life is being given to Arjuna. Arjuna is perceiving life from his own eyesight or from his own thinking. He has a certain perspective. With that he is watching life and making judgments about life. But Bhagavan is giving another dimension. As we said last time, that Bhagavan is standing at a greater height and then seeing life. whereas Arjuna is standing below, down on the ground, and he is watching life. There is a difference between the two perceptions. He says, Bhagavan says, Bhutani, see the order of the verse, Avyaktadini Bhutani, Bhutani Avyakta Adini. He says Bhutas means living beings. Beings have come from where, what is their origin? Avyakta Adini. They have come from Avyakta. Avyakta etc. means unmanifest. They were unmanifest before. From somewhere they came. You don't know from where they came. People just come in your life. People means children, when there is a birth, from where that jiva is coming, we do not know. Avyakta dini bhutani. Bhutas come from unmanifest. Then in between, for some time they become manifest. Vyakta madhyani bharata. Hey bharata, in between for some time they become manifest. They glow, they shine. From darkness they come, they shine for some time. Then avyakta nidhanani eva. They go back again to nidhanani means go back. Nidhana means death or departure. Where do they go? Again to nidhana, again to unmanifestness. From unmanifest they come, in between they are manifest, and again they go back to unmanifest. Tatra ka paridevana. In this matter, what complaints, what crying, why this lamentation? See, for Bhagavan it is so simple. He is fully accepted. He says, you don't know from where people come, from where jivas come, you just don't know. Can you say, a child is born in our family. Can we say from where he has come? Or for ourselves also, for our own selves, can we say from which yoni we have come? Earlier, in which form we were, whether we were man or woman to begin with, whether we were human being, that is also a question. We may be some animal also, we don't know, bird also. What we were earlier, we don't know. From darkness we have come. Astrologers may say that this person is from Sarpa Yoni. And so many things they say, you know. But we have no guarantee. From darkness, you know, they give an example. That from a darkness, in the at night, arrow comes. And the arrow comes when the archer is throwing an arrow. From darkness it just shoots. He shoots and it comes. For a moment there is a sound, there is a light. Again it goes into darkness. From where you come, that also you don't know. And from and where will you go, that also nobody knows. If we knew, if we knew, we could do something about it. We could not, even then we could not do anything. But Bhagavan has absolutely given us no clue. No clue at all. Mahatma sometimes can make out. But that is also a conjecture. We are not sure. We are not sure. So life is just in between for some time. Looking at the time scale, you know, what is our life? The in the eternal scale of time, what is this few hundred, 80 to 100 years? Even if you live for 110 or 20, what is that in comparison to the eternal flow of time? Swamiji Maharaj says, you know, that if you, even rocks live longer than us, trees live longer than us. The tree in our garden, neem tree, peepal tree, all these trees, you know, they were there before we came and they will be there even after we go. Rocks live for longer years, so many hundreds of years. They have so many stories to tell. So many people came and went away. And they laugh at us. If they could speak, if rocks could speak, they would laugh. Oh, what are you? You are a pygmy.
and look at me. Even Dionysus was something. You are nothing. And I have seen Dionysus also disappearing from this earth. What are you? Pygmy? Human being? If rock could speak, if rock had a tongue, it would tell us so many stories about so many people coming and going. So what is this life? Nothing. And in this small life also, there are so many divisions. We have divided childhood, then adolescence, then youth, and then old age. And then in that also, so many events are there. In such a small life also, so many events, and each and every event looms large on our mind. They are so heavy in our mind. Why did this happen? Why did that not happen? And we do not forget. We forget something. So, it is absolutely foolish, stupid, not to accept. See, we lament because we get associated. This association, you know, association with people bring about attachment. It brings about attachment. And that is the reason why we are not ready to accept the fact that this will go. He says, Utpannani Chaprag Maranat, before the Jiva dies, in between Vyakta Madhyani, it just appears before us. And again it goes back to avyakta nidanani eva. Again it goes to darkness. See, the people whom we love so much, our parents, our children, our spouse, when do we love them? When they are before us. From where they have come, from where they will go, and where they will go, we just don't know anything. Life is not a joke. It is a very serious matter, you know. This shows what ignorance is doing to us. Ignorance means not knowing the self results into all this. It just pushes you to life and death. Ignorance does this, pushes you into life, takes you away again, pushes you somewhere else, will take you away from there. So don't allow ignorance to take hold of your life. Don't allow ignorance to rule your life. We have no pramad in life. That is what Bhagavan is saying, Arjuna, telling that, get up. If you give in to this ignorance, you will be going from birth to death, birth to death, birth to death. And in between the birth and death, there will be so many people coming into your life for some time. And if you get attached to them, then when you have to depart, or when they have to depart, it will bring about so much of lamentation if you get attached. But if you accept that, yes, we are here for some time together. Just as, you know, in a train, when you are traveling together, in a train, in a compartment of the train, you are all together. All strangers. Somebody has boarded from Ahmedabad. Somebody boards from Vadodara. Somebody boards from Surat. Everybody boards, and then one by one they come. And when you are together in the compartment, you start talking to each other. Talk, laugh, share your informations. From where are you? What are you doing? How many children? People start asking everything immediately. Whether are you married or not? Why are you? If some people are, you know, very bold. Why are you not married? Why didn't you do this? Why didn't you? They start asking. And then you get closer also. In the train also, passengers get closer. They share everything. They eat together. You pay for them. They pay for you. Everything. And you do eat my mango, eat this, eat that. People bring so many things. Everything is going on very well. And when the station comes, Surat has come. Now this fellow has to get down. And he gets down. And this fellow will not, oh, don't get down. Please don't get down. I will not live without you. I cannot live without you.
They take phone numbers, okay, that much you can do, but nothing more than that. That will also get down, and when your time comes, you will also get down. That doesn't stop you from being friends to each other, sharing your information. But when the time comes, one has to go. One has to get down. That is what life is. And it is very likely that you are never going to meet again. If you meet, okay. But it is very likely that you may not meet the same passenger again in your life. You may not. Very unlikely. Life is like that only. We are all together for some time. Accept it. No, we will, so I will not look at you because again we may not meet. No. Help each other. Share each other. Help in that much time. But when the time comes, get down. Proceed with life. Life journey has to just go on. If you can do something about stopping this journey by reaching the destination. Reach the destination soon. Don't stop anywhere. After getting down also, don't remember that person. Remembering is fine. But I cannot go to my work. Even after going to work, the person is there in your head. So you can't forget and you can't do your... Stop all this emotionalism. See, this is what Bhagavan is saying. That life is like this. He is giving him, showing him this fact of life. Don't get stuck anywhere. Don't get stuck. If you are stuck, finish. Your time is wasted. Your energy is wasted. So much of energy goes, you know. Some people get stuck there. Life comes to a stop for them. Because of that, that person has already proceeded. He has already proceeded, he or she. And one beautiful thing is, Bhagavan has not given us memory about this. Very beautiful. Once you go, you forget. Close the doors forever. They say, okay, for 7 lives we are together. Okay, come. But but you don't know, even if the same person comes in your life. Do you know? Do you reckon? In the life before that we were together. Do you recognize? Then why insist that we should be together for 7 lives? Forget it. Just forget all this business. So, this is what Tatra Ka Paridev. In Mahabharata also there is a verse, Mahabharata Shanti. Adarshanad Apatitaha. From Adarshanam he has come. Punascha Adarshanam Gataha. He will again go back to Adarshanam. Means unmanifest. Na Asau Tava. He is not yours. Na Tasyatvam. You are not his. Mine and yours. Mine and yours. Vrutha ka paridevana. He says, why do you complain? Vrutha, see in Mahabharata also, this kind of verse was there. In Mandukya Upanishad, there is a beautiful verse. Adavante chayan nasti. This was person, in the beginning he was not there. In the end, you will not see. Vartamane, another dimension is there. In between also you are not there. Don't worry about this, but this is what is said. Bhashyakara says, Kova pralapaha. Why do you cry like this? For what? Adrishta, drishta, pranashta, branti bhuteshu. This beings, this branti bhuteshu, we are all ignorant. And ignorance should not be validated. Try to come out of ignorance. You also come out and help others to come out. Help others also to come out from this. That is what is being said here. Did I tell you last time about Parikshit? In Bhagavata, did I tell you that incident? You know very well that Parikshit,
the grandson of Arjuna. He is the only one person remaining in the whole family, and he was bitten by the spore saying that astrologers had said that he will be bitten by Takshak snake called Takshak, because he had committed a crime unknowingly, and Takshak was to come and bite him. So now Parikshit decided that in the death was imminent in 7 days. In 7 days it was to come. So now Parikshit said, I must do something with my life. So he was in search of a sage, some Rishi Muni or Mahatma who can help him. And after meeting so many, he found Shukadevji. Shukadevji before him, he goes and prays to Shukadevji that please help me. Shukadevji says, what is your problem? You tell me your problem. Then Parikshit says, I'm going to die within 7 days. So please help me. Death is looming large, is impending. So Shukadevji is laughing. He's laughing so much. Parikshit saying, I have come for solution to my problem, O sir. And you are laughing. Please do something. Shukadevji says, I'm laughing because you know that you are going to die in 7 days. That much guarantees you are sure about when the death is coming. When it is coming, you know. When you know at what, which moment death is going to come, you can do something about it. At least sit down and now start taking Lord's name. Others don't even know when death is going to come. At least you have 7 days. We may not have 7 days also. Who knows? Who knows? Is this gamble only? We just don't know anything. And we are merrily enjoying life. There is nothing wrong in enjoying. But have you finished your work? Have you finished? Swamiji Maharaj says, time is ticking like a time bomb. Time bomb is set. It is set and tied somewhere. Every moment tick, 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 tick is going on. When will that tick be over and the bomb will blast? We do not know. It may be the last moment, and still we are just unaware of everything. At least you know, so you can do something about it. Sit down. Parikshit said, I will do anything you tell me. He said, listen to Lord's Katha. And within 7 days, he was liberated. He was liberated completely. He forgot eating, drinking. Shukadevji say, eat little bit in between. Do some phalahar. Phalahar. Says, no phalahar. I have no desire. I am just enjoying Lord's Katha. I am engrossed and I am ready to die. I am ready to die. Because I have done Lord's darshan. I am seeing Lord through your mouth. From the words coming out from your mouth, I have seen what is there to be seen. I am ready now. So, life is like that. Be prepared. That is what it is being said. Don't sit and cry. They have gone, you will also go. Don't interfere. Interfere with facts. That is what is being said. After Lord is saying all this, then he saw and looked at Arjuna. I am saying so much about the paramarthic reality, about vyavaric reality, but still sorrow doesn't grow from your face. Still sorrow is not going from your face. Your face is still larger. There is no happiness. There is no cheerfulness on your face. Then Bhagavan realized that it is wrong to expect him to understand everything so soon. It is not easy to understand this subject so soon. That Bhagavan realized. Bhagavan realized. He says, Bhashyakara in between fills up the gaps for us. Durvigneyaha ayam prakrutaha atma. He realized that atma is durvigneya. Durvigneya means it is difficult to understand. It is not an easy subject for everyone. It is not easy to understand Atma. Kim tvam eva ekam upalabhe. Why should I become impatient with you? Sometimes teachers become impatient. You don't understand this much. I'm lecturing, shouting, and I'm repeating the same thing again and again, 10 times, and still you don't understand. What kind of buddhi you have? What is this? Sometimes teacher get up impatient, you know, with students. Then he realized, oh, this is for everyone. Everybody is in the same thing, same way. So I need not be impatient with Arjuna alone. Sadharane Branti Nimitte. Atma is confused by everyone. The biggest irony of our life is that we don't know ourselves. If I don't know this, it is okay. There are so many things in the world I need not know. I need not go and inquire about everything. Oh, what is that? What is that? It's okay. You need not know. But this I don't know. Who am I? That also I don't know. But it is a fact, nobody knows. Sadharane Branti Nimitte. This is sadharana for everyone. And it is difficult subject for, by no means it is difficult. Because it is unmet, because it is not vyakta. See, other things in life are vyakta. Bhagavan said, avyaktaha, avikaryaha, achintyaha. It has no attributes, just as this has its attribute. It is lemon color. It has certain square shape. It does this kind of work. Holds the paper. So when I explain all this, you know, it is like the clock clip. This object is a... When I explain and describe this object, you will have some idea. But about Atma, what to do? It is not an object of your perception. That is the biggest problem. It is not an object of perception. And that is why people confuse. People take this to be Atma because this is object of perception. This is something concrete. This has shape. This has form. This has length. This has width. This has attributes. But what about Atma? No shape, no form, no gunas, no dharma. Never comes before you and says, I am Atma. Never happens. So naturally, now Bhagavan, tube light to Bhagavan. Oh, I understand your problem. So then he says, 29th verse.
Aashcharyavat pashyati kashchidenam. Aashcharyavad vadati tathaiva chanyah. Aashcharya, that is vad vadati. Aashcharyavad vadati tathaiva chanyah. Aashcharyavad vadati tathaiva chanyah. Aashcharyavachainamanyashrunoti. Shrutvapyenam vedana chaiva kashchita.
Now Bhagavan says, I understand your problem. Atma is indeed like that only. What is Atma? Wondrous thing. Ashcharya, Atma is Ashcharya. Now so many Ashcharyas, Ashcharya means wonder. Wonder. Which you have, wonder means something you have never thought of. Something which you have never comprehended. And it just, suddenly you see. That is called Ashcharya. So he says, I understand. Ashcharyavat pashyati kashchid enam. Enam means the Atma which is under discussion. Enam kashchit. Somebody sees this Atma. Aashcharyavat pashyati. Enam kashchit ashcharyavat pashyati. Somebody sees this Atma, how? With ashcharya. Oh, Atma. I am Atma. Like that. Then second ashcharya. Cha anyaha tata eva anyaha ashcharyavat vadati. Similarly, somebody talks about this Atma is also ashcharya. Somebody who talks about Atma is also ashcharya. Why? Because there are no attributes in Atma. How will you explain? And still there is acharya or a speaker, vakta, who talks about Atma. So that is also ashcharya. Then now what is the third ashcharya? Anyaha shrunoti ashcharyavat cha. One more ashcharya. What? That somebody listens to this Atma. Somebody comes to listen about Atma. Please talk to me about Atma. That is also a wonder. Why? Because you are coming, you have come to hear about your own self. No, that is also biggest thing, that you don't know yourself and you have come to hear about yourself. And what will you hear? Because Atma, Vakta cannot describe Atma. Vakta cannot describe Atma, and still Shrota comes to hear about Atma. That is also wonder. And now greatest wonder. What wonder? Enam Shrutva api. Shrutva api enam. Enam means this Atma. Having heard about this Atma. Vedana chaiva kashchit. People don't know. That is also wonder. Even after Bhagavan is greater, he says, even after explaining about Atma, hearing about Atma, even after hearing about Atma, people, kashchit means somebody doesn't know about it. That is also ashcharya. There is nothing, there is absolutely nothing without wonder about Atma. Speaker also, Atma itself is wonder. Speaker is also wonder. Hearer also is a wonder. And after listening, if you do not know Atma, that is also a wonder. That means it is like that only. So now, this verse is something like, is taken from Kathopanishad. In Kathopanishad, there is a verse, you know, Shravanayapi Bahubiriyona Labhyate. The verse, similarly, Bhagwan has taken from that. Shravana, Bhagwan says there, not Bhagwan, but Yamaraja there says in Kathopanishad, ke Shravanayapi Bahubiriyona, people do not get a chance to listen. Shravana also is not possible. It is punyas, it is the result of punya only. That you have a chance to come and listen for Atma, listen about Atma, is the biggest grace of God, biggest anugraha of Ishvara. And shrutvapi, shravanayapi bahubiryo na labhyate, shrunvantopi bahavo yamna vidyuhu. Even after listening, most of the people do not know about it. So subject is tough, subject is not all that easy. So don't think one has to work hard, one has to pay attention, one has to have commitment. No, there should be commitment in life, that I want to know. So that is what is required. What Bhagavana says, ashcharyavat, ashcharyam, adrushta purvam, adbhutam akasma drishyamanam tenatulyam. There is, supposing there is something, you know, which you have never seen before, and suddenly you see the tallest building for about 200 stories, supposing. You have never seen, and suddenly you see it one day. Then you see, oh, wonder, the wonders of the world. Supposing you see something, you know, water is climbing down, water comes down from slope, from higher level to lower level. But supposing water went up naturally, without horsepower. Supposing water went up, then it would be wonder. There is a place, you know, they say in in Tulsishyam. They say there is a place in Tulsishyam where cars, etc., you know, they're on their own, they go up without you having to do anything. That is what I have heard. They just go up, some gravitational force. That they come down on the slope, if you don't have put the brake or handbrake, then it will come down. If the car is not in gear, then it will come down from the slope. But there is a place where cars go up. There, it is a big wonder. I'm just telling you an example. Similarly, Atma is something like that. Until you came to here, we never knew that we are whole. WHOLE. Teacher tells us that Atma is all pervasive. There is not a single space, place where Atma is not. Atma is even more pervasive than space. Oh, is it like that? I thought I am only this much. And now I come to know that I am all pervasive. I am Nitya. Body dies, Atma doesn't die. I never knew that. When Arjuna is seeing and listening to all this, he is definitely wonderstruck. I am Nitya and nobody dies. Nothing happens to Atma. Shastras cannot do anything. Fire cannot burn it. Oh, is it like that? Is it so powerful? Is it so great? So subtle? Yes. What is another wonder about Atma? It is of the nature of happiness. Oh, I am of the nature of happiness. I never knew that. Teacher says, Atma is already happy. You don't have to go in search of happiness and beg from the world. It is already happy. Oh, is it like that? Whole of my life I have been looking for happiness. I am striving for happiness. And you say you are already happy. Yes, you are already of the nature of happiness. Not even parts of happiness. The happiness which you see in the world is only flakes of the potato chips. You are the whole potato. And in the world you see only amsha of it. Oh, I am the ocean of happiness. Yes. I am of the nature of peace. Yes. And I am thinking that there is no peace in my life. I want to go to a quiet place to have some peace. You need not. You are of the nature of peace, prashantam. You are shuddha. I never knew this. That is a wonder that you never knew this. Atma is vivarta. Vivarta means without undergoing any change. It has become the cause of creation. You mean to say I am the cause of creation? Yes. But I have no shakti. I don't have material to build my house also. I have no material. No know-how to make my house, to make a table also. And you are talking that you are the creator of this world. Yes. You are creator. And what kind of creator? Mind-boggling. Vivartakaran. Vivartakaran means without undergoing any change, I have made this creation. Without spending a single penny, I have made this whole creation. Without changing myself, without taking away anything from me, the whole creation has come about. What is all this? Wonders. All these are wonders, you know. What else? Did you ever hear of any such thing? So, wise man looks at Atma in this way. And moment he realizes this nature of Atma, he is fulfilled. He is happy. No complaint. Happy with himself as he is. He may be a poor fellow outside, but inside he is happy. Why? Because he is the self. So, Ashrivan. People see, wise men see Atma in this manner. Then what else? Ascharya vadati. One who speaks about Atma. Ascharya vad enam vadati. Tatha evacha anyaha. One who speaks about Atma is also a wonder. Why? Why? One who speaks about Atma, that is the speaker, Acharya also is a wonder. To come across a teacher in our life, to come across a proper teacher, huh? There may be so many teachers. So many people claiming to know everything. So many Bhagavans are also roaming about. I am Bhagavan, I am Bhagavan, I am Math. But to find a right teacher in your life is also wonder. Why did sometimes we wonder, you know, how come I got all these possibilities? Sometimes you wonder, how come all of a sudden from somewhere I came to know such Mahatmas, such Shastra, born in such good family, having all these facilities, how come? You just don't know. Wonder. It is a wonder. And coming to think of the nature of Atma, as I said, Nirguna, it is Nirguna, Nirakara, Nirvishesha. What will you talk about it? It has no gunas. If I have to explain to you about laddu, then I can say it is yellow color. It is like a tennis ball. It is sweet. And it is in between crevices. In between there is elaichi. In between there is mari. What is called mari? Pepper. So many things. You can say something. I will get some idea. Even if I have to an American, if I say this, he will have some idea. But because laddu lends itself for some description. But what about Atma? How can I say? It is longer, it is shorter. You can't say anything. And still speaker speaks. Shastras are there. Upanishads and Upanishads, Gita, Bhagavan himself is speaking. So, through Lakshana, by implied manner, Atma is pointed. You are not the body, you are not this mind, you are not this prana, you are not this sense organs, you are not intellect. After negating all this, what remains is you. Like that, some idea can be given about Atma. That is also a wonder. Speaker is a big wonder. And one second thing, why should he speak first of all? Why should he take the trouble to speak? I know. If you don't know, go. Why should go to hell? Why should I worry? Why should I worry? But he worries. He worries and speaks about Shankaracharya ji. No, but Shiva only. Lord Shiva only. Sanaka Sanandan, these people were looking for a teacher. They are sons of Brahma ji. Huh? Sanaka Sanandan, all these people are. These four children are sons of Brahma ji. And then as soon as they were born, Manasaputra. Then Brahma ji ordered them. Now join in my business. What business? Procreating and looking after the world. You join Sanaka Sanandana, four children, they said, we are not ready. We want to be sannyasis. We are renunciate. We don't want to join in your, oh daddy, we are not interested. Right from the beginning, these problems are there between father and son. He says, Sanaka, Sanandana, Sanat Suta, all these four, we are not joining. Then Brahmaji got very angry. So these four went away in search of teacher. Then they went to Vishnu and Lakshmiji is pressing the feet. He said, what is this Bhagwan going to teach? He himself is attached with a woman. Not proper. Then went to Brahmaji. Brahmaji is listening to the sitar of Saraswati ji. He said, this is also, he is enjoying. What kind of, he cannot teach. So neglected, negated. Then went to Shiva. Here his heart was sunk. Why? Because Parvati is another half of Shiva. Right here. He says, this God, what will he teach? He is indulging. Not proper. Gave him up. So now they are totally frustrated. they started doing penance, you know, tapashira, find a teacher for us. Then one day Lord Shiva understood, I must come in a different form. Then he took the form of Dakshinamurti and he appeared before these four children. And now he is not speaking. Mauna Vyakya Prakatita. Mauna Vyakya. But Mauna Vyakya worked. His children, students are sitting, teacher is sitting, no conversation. But the state of mind is such, they were ready, you know, Tivra Jignyasa, Tivra Vairagya. So, Mauna Vyakya worked. It may not happen now. We need not try also. But what I am saying is that to find a teacher is also not easy. And for that teacher to speak, even though he is fulfilled, self-satisfied, still for him to take the trouble to teach is ahaituka daya sindhu, out of compassion. Then we see that Lord Shiva gave up the vatavruksha. Because now times have changed, now Mauna Vyakya will not work. So he came as Shankaracharya. Because now the Satyuga is not there. So Mauna, Sanak, Sanandana are not the students. So he came to us as Shankaracharya. Shankaracharya Madhyamam. So all these lines of teacher, you know. So it is purely compassion. Purely compassion. So, what I mean to say is that Atma is not available for being spoken of also. Vacho nivartante manasa saha. From where mind returns, because it can't be explained, it can't be thought of, achintya, earlier it was said, and still there is a speaker. And biggest wonder is, Ascharya vachya enam shrunoti. There are listeners to hear about this. Out of hundreds, there may be some who will have some jignyasa to ask about Atma. Who am I? This is reversing the process, huh? People just take the beaten track. Everybody follows what others are doing. Everybody follows, generally speaking, what others do. If everybody goes to America, I will also go. If everybody goes this line, I will do that. Generally, people follow the beaten track. Beaten means whatever is prevalent, that they will do. But there is one among million, who will ask, what is all this? My pursuits are not yielding any result. I have been trying and trying. I have not found anything. So maybe I don't know something. He questions. This one is also a wonder. Then after listening also, you know, somebody doesn't know is also a wonder. You know, just to tell you a joke. One Sangeet Samaro was going on and one person came. So many are sitting there. And the Panditji is singing Gopali Rag. He is singing Gopali Rag. And the fellows right before him, sitting before him, nodding, enjoying and giving everything. Tala also people give. Kya baat hai, what is going on? Then after that raga is over, then the Panditji, that fellow is telling that Panditji, ab Bhupali rag gaiye. He is saying, gaiye, now what to do? Panditji will fail, Panditji will have heart attack. But that is what exactly is. After listening to Vedanta, people still have questions. Questions is okay. you don't think you cannot have. But people say, I don't understand. What is the Atma? It goes above my head. Yesterday only somebody was telling me. This after that fellow is so sincere. He's so sincere. And I was really appreciating, you know, in my mind that really. And he does lot of dhyana. And so much he does. Then yesterday he is telling me, Mataji, what is this Upanishad? All the time talking about Atma. I don't understand anything. It is better to take Ram Ram, do the whole day Ram Ram Ram. I was wonderstruck.
Then why are you coming?
You can come. I am not telling you no. But it doesn't do anything to you. So same thing, you know. After listening, still it is not clear. It is what it is. Atma is difficult. It is difficult. So we should not take it lightly. That is what is being. So Bhagavan understood Arjuna's problem. Bhagavan understood Arjuna's problem. That still after saying so much you are lamenting, I can understand. It will take some time. Patiently be with this. And when he saw this, you know, Bhagavan changed the gear. He will change the gear. And where will he come to? Karma Yoga. Because of this. This not being able to grasp, not being able to understand, shows that there is lack of preparedness. That fundamental things which you have to learn are still not learnt. So he will change the gear. But now with verse 30, next verse we will do next tomorrow. He is completing one topic and then he will say another things. Okay, we will take tomorrow. Om Purnamadah Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Vashishyate. Om Shanti Shanti Shantihi. Harihi Om. Shri Gurubhyo Namaha. Harihi Om. So tomorrow we'll meet at 7. Tell your friends who have not come, you can inform them, and tomorrow we are meeting. Hari Om.